Hi, welcome to That's How We Do. Today we're going to have a look at this Humax RM108 remote control. No back on this one. First thing we're going to do is we're just going to test it to see if it's fully working. You can see that, you JP?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so our indicator will come on. Nothing there. There we go. We've got number 3 button working. All these buttons seem to be working okay. On off button, definitely got a problem with that one. Guide button, it's okay. Zero button. Okay, it's okay, just maybe a little bit of residue burn there. Up button. Okay button is got problems. So okay button, we're not getting nothing out of there. So okay and on button are the main problem ones at the minute. Around here, we've got the plus, minus. Okay, minus page, not too bad. Plus is a bit temperamental. Yeah. Okay, and we go all the way down to the bottom. Okay, so that's all the buttons. So the main two that aren't working, these two, although there may be some other residue around the rest of them. So let's take the batteries out and crack it open. All right, so I'm gonna work my way down this seam. I'll take my screwdriver. Is that correct on camera, JP?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna apply some pressure down here. I don't mind if I crack it a little bit because, there we go. You see I've cracked it a little bit, but it's all right, a little bit of plastic to break. You need to break it to break the contact. And I just go all the way up. And, oops, here we go. Bit more, apply a little bit more pressure. There we go, all the way around. So I've just cracked it all the way around that side, okay. And then I can show you like that. You can see the bottom there, I'm just gonna push it open a little bit more here. Easier said than done, JP. Easier said than done, bro.
Yeah, did.
All right, okay, and then I'm just gonna... There we go.
Mm-hmm.
And so, in effect... There we go. So I've been a bit rough with this one. I've broken off a couple of bits of the plastic, but I'm not too bothered with that. I'd rather have a working remote control than a couple of non-plastic bits. So as we open it up, you can see here, see, we see where the problem is. Here, I don't know if you can see on the camera, you see the residue here. Can you see that on the camera?
Mm-hmm.
Can you see that, yeah?
Yeah, but just, also the camera's small, yeah. The screen's small, so you can't really...
So you want to zoom in on that? Can you zoom in on that?
So you can't, but you can be able to see it when you blow it off.
Okay, so you'll be able to blow it up, yeah? And then on here, you'll see the residue as well. You'll be able to... Here, you'll see the residue here. All right, so this we need to clean, and this is what's stopping it. Funny enough, where the on-off button is, the on-off button, that one which was playing up. You see this area, it looks like it's got a little bit of dirt around here. The on-off button looks dry, so it doesn't look too bad, but yeah, we'll see, we'll give it a go. So we're gonna take our cloth, get a bit of WD-40 on there this time. We're gonna take it and I'm gonna work my way over the circuit board. You see that right, JP?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're working our way in. Make sure we get it. So we'll make sure that all the other contacts are also nice and clean. So they're all white. And then I'm gonna dry them again like we did last time. And dry them all up. Turn them around. Alright, so that circuit board. You see it's nice and clean now, nice and dry. Even up in that corner where there was a little bit before, there was a little bit of dirt and grime, that's all gone now, so that should be okay. Let's have a look at our button pad. So we had problems up here, it was problems with the on off button, and we had also problems with the okay button, if you remember, in the middle. So we'll clean that all up. I'll put a little bit of spray on my this 40 on in just to clean that up. Give that good old wipe down in the middle there. And I'll also give it a good old wipe down on those corner buttons which were causing me problems. Okay, the rest of the buttons around here, they were all right. I'll just give them a quick once over. All right, and then I'm going to take this one and dry it all off. Down there, the bottom. Just trying to do this one a little bit faster, JP, so it doesn't take as much time on the camera, okay?
Yeah, no, you've got you on 5 minutes for the moment.
I'm 5 minutes already?
Mm-hmm.
Got it. The 5 minutes just gone like that?
It's gone roughly.
Rapid,
yeah.
I feel like 5 minutes. I thought I'd been here like 2 minutes.
Yeah, no, you're on five.
Got it. All right, so there we go. We've cleaned up most of the remote control. That looks good. It's looking good there. Just step out the frame for a second and just make sure I've got my... I just want to make sure that particularly around these buttons where I had issues before, that they're all nice and dry. Okay. Yeah, so they're all nice and dry there. That should be fine now. So hopefully, now when we put this on, it should work. I'll clean that off before I put it on, but I'm just going to do a test. The stick came back on there. I'm going to put the batteries back in. Let's see. So we just line up our pad. Like that, and we'll push our number 3 button. Oops, what's something? There you go, number 3 button's working. So it was the on-off button we had problems with before. Oh, still playing up a bit. Not getting nothing on that on-off button. Let's try the OK button. OK button's playing up as well. So what this will indicate to me is that I will just try a couple of the other rubbers. I'm going to take the rubbers, and I'm just going to try them on that part of the circuit board and see what happens. See? It's working with the rubber. It's working with a different rubber, but with our on-off rubber, that's where we got the problem. Let's try the on-off rubber. That's our on-off rubber there. Let's try that one and see how that works when we put it on there. It's not working. The rubber is not working. So, in effect, we know the board's okay because we tested it with a different rubber. Look, we go back to here and we test it with a different rubber. There you go, look, it's working when you use a different rubber. But when we use the on-off rubber, straight on there, we're getting nothing. Nothing. So, we would have to put something on here, a bit of rubber, to repair that. But we haven't got any more. I haven't got anything to repair that at the minute. So what I'll do, I'll just see if I can just scrape it down a little bit, just to see if I can get a bit of extra sensitivity out of it. Just give it a scrape it off the top, just in case there's anything on there. Just going to scrape that out. I don't know if this is going to fix it or not, but all I could see from that last one is that it was the rubber. It wasn't quite connected, so I'm just going to give it a scrape. Let's try that rubber again now, shall we? That's on-off rubber. I don't know if this is going to work, but... Still no joy with that rubber. Definitely a no-go. It's a bust. I'm just trying to... Yeah. That's a bust. Well, I ain't really going to use this one, but I do have another one here, just in case. And on this one, let me just see what the problem is. On this one, let me take the battery out of here. Sometimes I can take one or not. We'll see. Look, same problem on the second remote, same problem. Okay button not working. Look, on off button not working. Standard. All right, let's open up this one and have a quick look and see if we can do a residue repair on it. I'm just gonna... Yeah, yeah, you can talk. All right, well, I didn't do too much good. Let's try.
What time is Marlon coming?
When I go home.
You?
Mm-hmm. There we go. Got in there. Good to put a little bit of pressure in, but... There we go. Cracked it. All the way up here. Cracked it there. See? It's open there. Cracked it again. All right. Yeah, I damaged a little bit, but I'd rather... Try and get it working. There we go, that's that one open. Right, so let's have a look. On this one, I've got two circuit boards again. You'll be able to see the difference. One you can see is a little bit dirtier than the other, but that's when we cleaned. But we know that's working. It's just the on-off button we had the problem with. So let me take him out of there. And let's clean this circuit board quickly and see if we can get a result on this one. You don't always get it first time, but I'm not really someone to repair the boards, but the board was fine. It was just the rubber that was the issue. Let's clean this one up. Doesn't work perfectly. Let's clean him off. Yeah. All the way down. Even though it's the same remote control, see, it's slightly different interior. Look at that, look, you've got slightly different chips down here on this RM108 Humax. But there we go, so that's that clean. Before I, okay, I'm gonna, here's the rubber that we were using, and we had problems here in the center of this one and the on off button. So I'm just gonna do a quick check and see if it works. I'm gonna put the batteries in. Let's have a look. Batteries in. All right, so let's push our buttons. Oops, put them in place. There we go. Two's working. Ah, see that? On off is working now on this one. And okay is working. That's great. Let's just try this one on our other circuit board here. See if we get any joy. Just to double check. On off button. Ah, look. Hold on. What's happened here? This one's not. Oh. Didn't put batteries in there. Right, but let's just say we can just. This would just help us to. Let me just double check and see.
This battery's on 5%. So.
Okay, I mean, we'll wrap it up.
Obviously, we can pause it and then we can swap it.
Ah, okay. So you see, this is definitely the rubber that was the issue. So this first rubber from the first one was definitely the issue. And I don't really know how to repair these any more than that, to be honest. So I'm going to just dash this out. We're going to get rid of this. Okay. But we know that both the circuit boards are working fine. All right. So all I need to do now is just to clean this baby up a little bit. Give her a brush off. So we ain't got all the little dirty bits in there. Alright, so we give her a good brush off in the centre, like that. And brush her off. We've got a team of people that clean all of our remote controls, but when we do repairs, I just do that like that. Alright, so I will take my, now as I'm putting this remote control back together, these two look the same. Yeah, they look pretty much the same, don't they? Yeah, look good. Now which one, do you think one of them looks better than the other? Well, this one looks a little bit better, I think. So maybe I'll use this one.
Yeah, this one's on 1%. Might have to pause it.
Pause it. Oh, right, I've just put this on. Put this in. I'm gonna. Oh, I can't forget to put my end connector in here. Just my end bit for my IR receiver. Sorry about that. We had to do a quick battery change on that one, so we just put a new battery in. But I'm gonna put this one back in place. I put the infrared bit back in there. Let's squeeze him back in. There we go. Oop, and the two buttons stuck in. All right, let's push this remote control back in. So even though I did snap it around the edges, you see it goes back in. I'll just click that in there, click that in there. All right, I did do a little bit extra damage to it. I shouldn't have really have done that. That's me, it's just me getting a bit carried away. I could have been a bit more gentle with that, but it is what it is. I do have the other one, so if I want to, I'll just take it off of that one and stick it onto that one. So then I've got one without the damaged case. I'll take out put the infrared bit back in there. Put you back in. There we go, put Mr. Infrared back in. Put Mr. Remote back in. Get those hairs. Okay, and then put him on there. So, I did have two remotes. And I did slightly damage one, as you see down here. I did damage him a little bit, but the circuit board is good, so we can use this for another remote at a later point. But this one now, we should have a completely working remote control. Just need to get it a little bit extra clean. So let's put the batteries in and make sure she is good. Batteries in. Okay, they're in there. Okay, moment of truth. So test on off button. Hey, we are good. On off button. Okay button. We are good. Rest of the buttons. Oh, we are in the game. Just double check, make sure. All the buttons. We've got to make sure we go all the way down. You don't want somebody telling you that it's not working after you did it. Done. Perfect. So this remote control is all fixed now. All we just need to put back on there and we're good to go. A little minor damage, but at least it's working. We're good for another couple of years. Thank you.